Is the fighting senator Manny Pacquiao correct in saying corruption has gotten worse under the Duterte administration? We'll now be speaking to the chairman of the Presidential Anti-Corruption Commission, Greco Bellica. Chairman, good afternoon to you, and thanks for joining us today.
Good afternoon, Ma'am Karen, and to all our listeners and viewers. Thank you for having us today.
It's Carmina Constantino po.
Kanina Sorry, Carmina. It's okay.
Kinabahan din ako kasi we only had a few seconds to go. Wala pa kayo sa upuan ninyo. I thought you were gonna lead into an empty seat. Anyway, what do you make of Senator Manny Pacquiao's claims that corruption in the country has doubled, has tripled during the time of President Rodrigo Duterte's administration? Go ahead, Chairman.
Yes, ma'am. What has doubled and tripled are the efforts of government to combat corruption, not corruption. And the best example is the exposés that have been happening all over government. Now we have a president who weekly calls out the names of people that are corrupt in office. Now you have offices like the PACC who weekly files with the Office of the Ombudsman cases against high-ranking government officials. We have done that every week. Now you have offices like the Anti-Deceptive Authority, Task Force Against Corruption, and a very active ombudsman who works tirelessly to fight corruption. Those are the things that doubled. A concrete example will be the field health. The anomalies in field health have been happening since 2000, pero because of but the expose only happened in 2019, because people are now talking about it and speaking about it because of the high trust that they are giving or they have with the president. So ulitin ko lang po sa summary, hindi po nagdoble, triple ang corruption. Ang nagdoble po at triple or more are the efforts in fighting corruption.
Pero kung nagdoble at triple yung efforts, if your efforts in fighting corruption has tripled and doubled during this time, and yet we still hear complaints, your office continues to receive complaints of corruption, doesn't that mean that corruption is still there? You may be fighting it, but it's still there. And the fact that you're tripling, doubling your efforts, and yet it's still there, isn't that sort of proof that what the senator was saying is actually true?
No, what the senator, I agree with the senator that there is corruption. There is really corruption in all governments around the world. There is no government without corruption. Even today, the Philippines has corruption. That is precisely why we are here. The PACC, ARTA, Task Force Against Corruption, and the Ombudsman and the anti-corruption committees that are being formed today, as we speak today, and the Anti-Corruption Coordinating Council that was before and that is being established, is being formed to fight corruption po. Corruption can never be zeroed. We are not saying that we have zeroed corruption. What we are saying is we are putting up institutions and continuously and tirelessly fighting corruption, because as long as there are people, there is corruption. Mas kakambal na po ng tao ang corruption. What we must do is to put institute offices, and improve systems, be transparent, make it as transparent as possible so that corruption will be hard to perform, and corrupt government officials will be exposed and will be kicked out of office and penalized now.
All right. You said a while ago that every week you've been filing cases against corrupt officials. Give us an example. Last week, for example, how many cases did you file? Who are these people that you filed cases against before the Office of the Ombudsman?
Yes, last week we filed against 11 government officials with the LRPA and with the Department of Budget and Management for a 170 million anomalous transaction in LRT1 for delivering substandard instruments far from what was approved through bidding. These are eight government officials and three private contractors. This week, we filed against officers of the Department of Health. Next week, we'll be filing against officials of the Department of Agriculture. Officers ranking from undersecretary to the directors down to the inspection engineers. Cases have been filed against them. Just to give you a brief background, ma'am, the PACC has already received 13,000 reports and complaints from 2018. 157 cases from those cases have been filed with the Office of the Ombudsman. 45 high-ranking government officials was already expelled from office by the president because of the PACC reports. 25 PhilHealth officers that was involved in corruption was fired out, and cases was filed against them with the Office of the Ombudsman, including the highest ranking government official or the government official in PhilHealth, which was the former president of PhilHealth, who has the rank of undersecretary. So 8888 is continuously receiving reports to about 2,500 reports a day. So you can just imagine the activities that this government is performing against corruption. And we will be continuing to do this, as we have promised when I assumed chairman of the commission, that we will be filing cases against high-ranking government officials every week until the president's term is office. This is to bring out, to send out a very strong signal to all government employees to stop corruption, to remember that public office is a public trust, and mostly to remember or to tell them that the campaign of the president against corruption is very, very serious.
What have you done, Chairman Belica, since Senator Manny Pacquiao came out with his allegations, specifically mentioning Health Secretary Francisco Duque and the Department of Health as, you know, being involved in corrupt activities, especially during the time of this pandemic, Chairman?
I've been waiting for the details of Senator Manny Pacquiao's revelation. I've asked him to, if he will indulge us, to give us the reports that he has, so we can investigate it, and because we are seriously interested to know the truth, and if evidence warrants, file cases and expose this to the public and give it to the president. Number one. Number two, we have called all of the government offices just today to hold an anti-corruption meeting that included the Department of Health with Secretary Duque. I just got off over a Zoom meeting with all government offices to strengthen and to reiterate with them the fight against corruption, or to support the fight against corruption, and to create anti-corruption committees within their offices, down to the lowest office of their bureaucracy, to help and strengthen the fight against corruption. Thirdly, we will be conducting a mass deputation of private sectors and anti-corruption advocates who would like to help the government in the fight against corruption. In fact, ma'am, this has been in the plan of a PACC Roadmap 2022 when I assumed office this March. Timely, siguro itong expose or controversies that happened today. Well, now we can highlight the plans and the efforts that PACC has done.
But this administration only has a few months left in its lifetime, and you're only doing that now?
I was appointed chairman of the PACC this March, and right after April, we presented our plan of action. We launched Project Kasanga. We have signed up, we are signing up all agencies of government to assist the fight against corruption, and to resign from public office if they ever get into corruption and we find out. We have signed them up to strengthen the anti-corruption fight by creating the anti-corruption committees. And we have promised the public that we will file cases every week, and we have done that. If I would have been in office longer before March of this year, I could have started this many, many years ago. Pero yung ginawa ko po ngayon is a product of the learnings that I have received or I have got from the time I was appointed commissioner pa lamang po noong 2018. Mm-hmm. And now that I became chairman, so bringing this learning now that I am the helm of the office, ito rin po agad na aming ginagawa para ma-institutionalize. We have jailed over 20 government officials already through entrapment, other than the cases that we have been investigating and filed.
Chairman, sorry to be there because we're running out of time and we have more questions to ask you. You said a while ago that you're just really waiting for details, more details from the senator. But isn't it incumbent upon you as chairman of the PACC to seek him out, not just wait until he says other? Go ahead.
I already did that, ma'am. I said that a while ago. That is the first item that I said, that I've already asked him if he would indulge us, send us the report that he has, because we want to know details, because we want to know what the cases he has, because we already have 9 cases against the DOH being investigated here in PACC. We have finished and submitted, I think, 4 of them to the Office of the President, and we are investigating another 5. So I am, and we are very interested to hear what he has. If these are new, I hope these are new evidences or new issues and new cases, because we are already investigating 9 cases. That includes Secretary Duque in several of those cases, ma'am. And Secretary Duque knows that because he has been answering in our investigation.
What's the nature of these cases involving Secretary Duque?
Marami po yan. Yung sa IRM, all the filial cases. Nasasama po si Secretary Duque doon dahil siya po ang head na agency doon po sa illegal, yung mga resolutions na inilibas ng filial office. Yun po.
What about the senator was saying about cases involving the DOH and Secretary Duque involving PPEs?
Opo, meron din po kaming investigation dyan sa PPEs and overpriced test kits. Meron din po kaming ginagawa dyan, investigation.
All right. And you said that you've already reached out to the senator. Kailan po nangyari yung pag-uusap ninyo? Ano pong sinabi ni Senator Pacquiao sa inyo?
Wala po ako natatanggap na sagot kay Senator Manny. He will answer naman pagka kailangan. Magkaibigan naman po kami ni Senator Manny. He's a good man. The last time we talked was probably a year ago when he asked me to investigate on a case, which I did. Similar to any other official and any ordinary person who comes to me on a daily basis or calls me up on a daily basis to ask cases to be investigated. Ginagawa po namin yan.
So nabanggit niyo na rin. Yeah, nabanggit niyo na rin, Chairman, that you're friends with the senator. And because you're friends with the senator, do you believe that he's the kind of person who will just mouth these allegations without any proof backing them up?
That's why I'm waiting, because I want to know. Kung meron po, we talk about other issues as friends, our advocacies and our faith. But we have not talked about corruption. Only once. We've talked about corruption once with the case that he referred to me. So that's why I want to work with him in this case that he has. And I will do my job as PACC chairman, and I will use the authority given to me and government to investigate and get to the bottom and get to the truth of all these allegations.
A while ago, you said that there can never be zero corruption in government. You said kakambal na ng tao ang korupsyon. But isn't it true, Chairman Belica, that was one of the pillars of the campaign of then-candidate President Duterte to eliminate corruption? Are you saying that the president has failed in this endeavor?
No, the president has succeeded in the fight against corruption, and we see it by the trust of the people being given to him. Sinasabi ko, ma'am, you can have anyone sit in office, even Superman sit in office. He will never eliminate corruption because it is the nature, is in the nature of man to corrupt. What government must do is to put up institution and make corruption hard for those who will attempt to corrupt government and steal from public funds and abuse their authority.
Are the laws in place enough to address corruption here in the Philippines, Chairman?
No, definitely not. We have very weak laws to address corruption. And that's why one of the things that PCC is doing is preparing a legislative agenda that will be passed to Congress and the Senate and the Office of the President to compile all the learnings that we have had during our term in office to help the fight, to strengthen the fight against corruption. Example, ang examples po dyan, yung jurisdiction. We hope if PCC had more jurisdiction and jurisdiction over all government officials, we could do better. If there is we hope to set up anti-corruption police, because when you talk about crime, you have the police. When you talk about terrorism, you have the soldiers. When you talk about corruption, you should have your own anti-corruption police. We also wish that the rules in investigation can be hastened to facilitate and to finish cases much quicker. And if we can strengthen the office of the ombudsman, give it funds so that it can give more courts, so it can build more courts, employ more people to address corruption in all levels of government, and put up the offices in all levels of government so that the cases do not pile up in the office of the ombudsman. Mas mabilis po ma-actionan ang corruption. And lastly, we hope and we have been advocating that death penalty be restored and corruption be made a heinous crime.
What about corruption involving the office of the president? Are you investigating any case as well regarding that?
That is our exact mandate, ma'am. That is the limit of our mandate. It's to investigate all officials under the executive department. So, yan po.
Anong mga kaso ang meron kayo ngayon?
Marami po yun, ma'am. As I've said, we have 13,000 cases. I cannot enumerate all of them. Meron dyan bidding, meron dyan abuse of authority, meron po dyan mga extortion. In fact, ang problema pa namin, ang daming nagsusumbong, wala naman nagpa-file. So, paano magpo-proceed ang kaso kung ganun. But then, we continue to do our job, build up the case and file cases. Investigate and file cases.
Going back to the cases involving the DOH and also Health Secretary Francisco Duque, has it been difficult for you to conduct your investigation precisely because the Health Secretary is still there and the President seems to still trust him? And we just heard from him recently that he won't fire the Secretary even if his fellow Cabinet Secretaries have advised the President to fire Health Secretary Duque.
No. That has not been a problem to us because the secretary, like all the other secretaries, are very cooperative with the investigation of the PACs. Yan po ang 100% ng katotohanan.
Okay, we're going to have to leave it at that. We've run out of time. PACC Chair Greco Belica, thank you for joining us this noon. Take care. Keep safe.
God bless, ma'am. Thank you.